Another edition of Cougar Insider Show here on MC22. My name is Cosmo, play-by-play voice for Columbia College, and the Cougar baseball coach, Darren Munns, with us here today. Coach, how are you?
Doing great. Thanks, Cosmo.
We're going to rewind the tape just a little bit. I know you got four games under your belt here to start this season, but we'll flash back to the start of the announcement that Bob Burchard, athletic director and basketball coach, made here a couple years ago that baseball was coming back to Columbia College. You're from the area. You're up the road at William Woods for the last, 10 seasons before that. What made you decide to throw your hat in the ring, to use a bad baseball pun, to go for the head job here to start this program?
Well, Cosmo, I thought it was a great opportunity. Columbia College, education speaks for itself, and the athletic department, their reputation also speaks for itself with all the success they've had over the years under Coach Burchard's leadership. And Columbia, Missouri also is a great town, as you know, a great college town. So I thought there was a lot of variables there that added up, and I was looking forward to a new challenge. And I think the program has a ton of potential.
Absolutely. And you go from, you coach a little bit at Harris Stowe in St. Louis, and then William Woods. So certainly you knew the conference, the AMC conference, a couple teams that are in the conference, and you get the head job, and literally there's no baseball hats, there's no baseballs, there's no bats. I know Coach Burchard's in. I'm not sure how I got somebody to agree to start a baseball program without even a bat, much less anything as far as making the start. But talk about that. That must have been pretty exciting / humbling and pretty scary as well, to literally take something from zero. Now, baseball had been, you know, at Columbia back 35 years ago, but to start from zilch, probably a whole range of emotions for that process, right?
For sure. I think the not having bats and balls wasn't as daunting as not having good players. That was the first challenge, is hitting the road recruiting, and I was very fortunate they gave me a good timeline, one full year to recruit, and it has been exciting. You're starting something brand new, brand new culture, brand new program, and I know our guys are excited, and we can't wait to get this season going.
A different kind of a challenge. Obviously, when you were the coach at William Woods, you're recruiting guys. You've got records and history, seasons that you've had, and performances, and finishing in the AMC and winning games, and to recruit from, as well as, you know, a program that's been there. How is it? What besides, hey, be a part of something brand new? I mean, was it that simple? Besides the education part, but I mean, it's obviously a completely different sales pitch, if you will, as you're going into these young men's houses to say, hey, come play baseball. We've never had a team before, but come play for me.
That's probably the greatest challenge, is you don't have tradition to lean on or past success, and you just have to sell recruits on the fact that, hey, we're going to get there sooner than later, and you can be a big part of it. And I found that many of our top recruits, who will be our top players, they were the type of kid that enjoyed a challenge, which is what you're looking for anyway in recruiting. And then, like I said, once they visited campus, they were really impressed. As you know, we have a great campus, a lot of great people here at Columbia College. And, I think once they got on campus and saw the direction we were headed and the mission that I was on and wanted the program to be on, and we were able to put together a good group.
I think it's pretty safe to say that if you look up and down the list of the teams that were here up until 4 or 5 years, 6 years ago, when the athletic department really exploded with the addition of the women's soccer team, you had the track and field, you had the cross country, the golf programs, they've all succeeded very quickly. So I think a lot of guys would think, okay, well, there's no reason to think that this baseball program doesn't have a legit shot to also be right there and contend in the AMC conference.
We hope so. I mean, that's the plan. I've leaned on some of the other coaches. They've been awesome people to work with as colleagues. And, our baseball conference in the AMC is really, really competitive. It's one of the best conferences in the country. We look forward to that challenge and relish that opportunity. But it's going to be a challenge. And I think we're going to get there sooner than later. And like I said, I really look forward to it.
As soon as, of course, where you were at before William Woods, I know Missouri Baptist is rated in the top 25. They've always got a solid program. So, yeah, definitely the work cut out for you. But I think that aspect of telling a player, hey, come play for us and you can be a part of the first team, a lot of firsts. And that's something that there's not that many opportunities for a guy to be able to come in and say, hey, I'm the guy. I was the first recruiter, the first, you know, big-time player to start this program and really be a part, especially somebody that's coming in out of high school, to be here, and who knows, by the time he's a senior where this program's at in 4 years. That's a unique opportunity to dangle that carrot as opposed to just, hey, come play for us. We've won some titles or won some conference games.
No, you're exactly right. You know, the opportunity to begin tradition and to begin a culture, and like you said, there's many, many firsts, and for you to be a part of that as a player, and then 10, 20, 30 years from now, you look back and come back in as alumni, you can say, hey, I was right there in the building blocks and got this thing started. I think it's pretty special.
Now, you guys will play. That's a question I get asked a lot when people come up to me or they say, hey, you're going to do the baseball games? And I said, yeah, where are they playing? Where are they playing? it's going to be out near at the Boone County Fairgrounds at the Atkins, the field out there, Atkins Black. I know you guys have done some renovations on it, and that process continues, and I think will probably always be kind of a work in progress over the years. Talk a little bit about what that field setup is going to be like and what it's like to have that off-campus facility.
When recruiting and our guys that are here, they still think they're playing at Busch Stadium. So, no, I'm just kidding, of course. No, the facility's awesome. You know, when I took the position and I got to talking to Coach Burchard administration about facilities, that was a natural fit because it's already built from a dimension standpoint. It's, you know, college / pro dimensions. It already has, you know, pro lights, pro lighting. So those things were in place, full irrigation system. There were a lot of really concrete blocks in place for a good field. And now a combination of the school and the City of Columbia in a partnership, and we've really enhanced it even further. So we're looking forward to that being our home. And you mentioned Atkins Black. It's the biggest field out there at the Atkins Baseball Complex. It's going to be our home. It's going to be Columbia Cougars everywhere, and we're really looking forward to it. We open the first weekend in March, and it's conference play versus Williams Baptist. So looking forward to that for sure.
Well, I know something, you know, here you go back 5, 6, 7 years ago with Coach Wendy Spratt and the softball program. Of course, their softball field used to be on campus where the Boone Science Building is now, and then obviously when that was moved off campus, the relationship that Columbia College continued to build with Parks and Rec, having the Cougar softball team at Rainbow, or at rather Antimi Black at their complex out there. I think that was one of the things that helped push that next step over, the domino over for baseball to happen. I know that was kind of in the master plan, and once that you realize that, yeah, it's not on campus, which would be the dream scenario to somehow have a baseball and softball field on campus, but with Columbia being so landlocked campus-wise, to be able to have that off campus, yeah, it's, you know, a little inconvenient to have the guys drive over there, but once you're there, you're ready to rock and roll.
Yeah, and we're fortunate to have, like I said, a facility like Atkins here in Columbia. That's, you know, what made it very possible to start baseball is that you have an off-campus facility when you are landlocked, as you mentioned, like we are here at CC.
And again, let's face it, Missouri, especially mid-Missouri, as we know, Mother Nature is a fickle woman, and not necessarily the easiest to practice baseball. So I know you've taken advantage of the turf room, some other things here at Columbia on campus and some other off-campus facilities to get your work in and the practice in when there's snow on the ground or ice on the ground.
For sure. And, you know, if you run your, quote, spring training in mid-Missouri in January and February, you better have some indoor planning and some facility planning in mind as a coach. And, you know, our guys have done a great job. They've worked their tails off. We have an indoor complex we use here. Fundamentals is the name of it. It's an all-turf facility. We have an agreement with them as well. So it's been great. We've used some different facilities to get our work in, but I feel like our guys were very prepared this past weekend. And as we move forward in our pre-non-conference, and then once we get into conference play, I like where we're at as a group and as far as preparation goes.
Talk about a couple of the assistants that you've got on your staff as you to lead this baseball program and as you build it up, because you go from coaching every day to then building the program. Before we get to your assistants, let me ask you this question. What was it like after coaching for so many years to not put on a baseball uniform and be in a dugout filling out a lineup card? Instead, you were building this program. That obviously a completely different challenge for you, Coach.
Yeah, selfishly, I hated it because, you know, I'm used to a season. You work and build up to your season in the spring. And last year, you know, I spent the entire year recruiting. We didn't have a team yet, and it was really, really different. But I also knew it was the best plan to give us a chance to be competitive year one. So it was definitely different. You know, last year in early February, I wasn't pulling on the pajamas, as they say, to start playing baseball. And instead, I was out on the road trying to see as many recruits as possible.
Yeah, different challenge, but obviously knowing in the back of your mind what now was going to be able to bring, it was probably well worth it, and a little different personal challenge for you as well.
Absolutely. You know, anytime you're building a normal recruiting class for most places is, you know, you're looking at, you know, 8 to 15 guys depending right. on the year. And in my case, you know, I'm looking at 35 to 40. So it was a challenge. I mean, that's probably the biggest challenge is just the sheer numbers. Yeah. But at the same time, it's very rewarding, and we have a great group assembled, and I can't wait to get going here.
Talk about a couple of your assistants real quick. Who's helping you in the dugout for Columbia College?
Well, Craig McAndrews. Craig played for me at Harris Stowe. He's an all-conference player, and then he was my assistant coach at William Woods for 9 seasons. Outstanding baseball person and an even better human being. So we're very blessed to have him. He will be a tremendous asset and a person for our players to be around. So I'm looking forward to working with him again. He's been great, and I'm looking forward to that. And then Caleb Bounds is our graduate assistant, and Caleb also played for me at William Woods and has done a great job so far, and I know he'll do a great job. He's getting his master's degree here at Columbia.
Cougars off to a start 2-2 after 4 games in Tennessee. We'll come back with the Cougar baseball coach, talk about the action that just took place, and a little preview ahead. Your first chance to see the Cougars in person coming up March 3rd and 4th out of Atkins Black, as Coach mentioned. We'll come back with more with the Cougar baseball coach Darren Munns here on the Cougar Insider on MC22.
I was just doing my job.
Medicom technicians are trained to do everything they can to help a customer. That's the power to simplify.
I was there to do a service upgrade, but I discovered that there was voltage on the electrical ground.
It really was a fire waiting to happen. The tech alerted the customer. They got an electrician over there right away.
When the customer called to thank me, I told her I was just doing my job. I'm Kip, and helping customers is what I love to do.
You know, there's nothing more gratifying than being able to help other people. Really, I think that's what we're meant to do on this earth. When you're out and you're helping people and you drive through the neighborhood, you see all of their belongings stacked up on the edge of the street. You don't judge them, you don't pick and choose. You take them as you find them and you help them.
There's always gonna be somewhere to go because the Red Cross is here.
They show up out of nowhere, the Red Cross. I don't know how they do it. When they show up, there's cots, there's beds, there's blankets, there's food, there's water. There's stuff, all this stuff that will take care of people right here, right now, right on the spot.
If it wasn't for the Red Cross, we wouldn't have a place to go. We wouldn't have the help. These people made us feel so welcome. It was a blessing.
The Red Cross to me means someone that actually will listen to my story and care that someone like me is out there and offered the help that y'all have offered.
And it's your help and your volunteerism and your donations that keep this running. Thank you.
When we really needed help, Red Cross was there. You were there when we needed you. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Talking Cougar baseball. That's fun to say. Columbia College baseball with the head coach, Darren Munns. My name is Cosmo, play-by-play voice for the Columbia College Cougars. You head to McKenzie, Tennessee, hop on the bus, and for the first time in 35 years, you watch Cougar baseball players head out on the field, and you get a win in the first ball game, a 6-5 victory. Had a little lead early on, and then they kind of came back on you, but you held them off, got the victory. Talk about what it was like to get a win in the first game in since 1982 for Columbia College.
It was really exciting. I mean, it was fun to see our group on the field together. You know, the college season, you know, you spend the fall playing fall ball, then you have the off season in the weight room, conditioning, the preseason, getting ready for the season. So it's a long time. It's a build up, and it really was a lot of fun. It was fun for our guys to win a game also versus a very good team, 6-5, so it was a good way to start the season.
Who was some of your guys that stood out for you in that win over the Wildcats down there?
Our starting pitcher, Zach Maskell, he's a senior, transferred from Lincoln University just down the road, and he was outstanding. He set the tone for us, gave us a really good start, and it made it a lot easier to play baseball, as it always is with starting pitchers.
Yeah,
he does his job.
Obviously, whatever the level is, whether it's NAIA or Major League Baseball, whatever it is, pitching obviously is probably the name of the game, and really the rest of your team can rally and goes the way that your starting hurlers go.
For sure. They set the tone for everything. The pitching and the catching just keeps the game in rhythm. And, you know, if you pitch and play defense, you always have a chance to win. And our guys hear me say that all the time. But it's the absolute facts, like you said, at all levels.
Third out goes up. It must have been. I know just getting the text alert and seeing the update and so many Cougar fans watching the live stats and some of the video things and seeing a lot of different celebratory messages and texts, and I know the sports information director Cindy Potter had a pretty funny little line after the victory of the 35-year winning streak continues since the last time there was baseball here at Columbia College in 1982. But to get the win in the first game as the coach and as the program, again, a special opportunity. Then you followed up with a second win in a row. I know that some scheduling moved around with weather down there, but the bats came alive. You put up 10 runs. You got a 10-4 win in the second game. Talk about what went right for CC in that one.
It was starting pitching again. Cody Ebert gave us 5 really strong innings and set the tone for us, and it made it really easy to play baseball. We had some cushion lead, and our guys swung the bats. And, you know, I don't want to be repetitive, but, I mean, we got 2 really good starts right out of the gate, and I was really proud of those guys. They're a couple of upperclassmen. They really did a good job leading our team with the way they handle the game on the mound with their mound presence and throwing strikes and just doing all the things you're supposed to do as a starter.
And then the last two games didn't quite go as smoothly. I know you want to forget the last one, especially the 11-1 loss. I guess we'll kind of go with what happens in McKenzie. Tennessee stays in McKenzie, but unfortunately it's up there. You had a 1-run loss, a 7-6 back and forth kind of ball game. What happened in that one?
The 7-6 game, we jumped out and scored 5 in the top of the first. And they went to their bullpen and used a couple really effective left-handers. And, you know, left-handed pitchers a mystery of the universe. you know, we kept working, but I give them credit. I think too often we criticize what we didn't do. And Bethel has a very strong team, and, you know, they did a good job going to their bullpen early and got some stops. And it came right down to the end, and they just made a couple more plays than we did and had a couple more clutch hits than we did late. So the game could have gone either way. Kind of like the first game. Both those games were very similar. Yeah. We won one of them and lost the other one.
And then the 11-1 loss didn't look good on the scoreboard, but what can you try and take away, and what is your staff trying to take away from that defeat and the 2-2 split series with coaching the guys getting ready for the next series down in Memphis?
Yeah, the last game, you know, we just didn't play defense, quite simply. And we have some moving parts right now in our infield, and we're still trying to figure some things out like most programs are around the country. And we learned a lot from not just the last game, but from the 4-game series. You know, it's one thing to practice, albeit a lot of it indoors, but you're practicing and you're trying to formulate your team. And it really comes to light when you get in a competitive setting against a good team on the road. And it's definitely very beneficial. You know, 2-2, you don't want to do that all year, obviously, but
right.
At the same time, you learn a lot about your team, and it's very beneficial moving forward.
And to start on the road, probably you're going to for pretty much the month of February. You get an opportunity to build some chemistry with the team. It's one thing to have the practices and being here around campus and in meetings and in training rooms and so on and so forth. But when you hop on a bus and you spend 3 or 4 days on the road, it's a different way to kind of build that chemistry. And early on for this program, that's really big. It's probably in some regards just as important as what happens between the lines.
You know, you're absolutely right, Cosmo. It's great to go on the road. You guys get to know each other. I mean, you're on a bus for 6-7 hours, and then you're in a hotel, out on team meals. I mean, all those things. I mean, you have to have good players to win, but it really helps the entire process when you're on the road. And I like it also because, you know, I like to go on the road early and play some good teams because it really builds your team. And if you look at the big process as a coach, I mean, we want to be ready for conference, and as importantly, once we get into the meat of our conference season and down the stretch. And I think everything's a process, and this part of it's really important when we go on the road all through February.
Christian Brothers University, your next opponent. You're going to play some games down in Memphis, Tennessee. Again, talking about the excitement that this program is built on having baseball on campus. I've seen some people on campus like, let's road trip to Memphis and watch the Cougars play baseball. I mean, that's exciting stuff. What do you know out of CB coming up this weekend?
I did a little bit of preliminary scout this morning. We'll take a deeper look this week, but they always have a really competitive program. They play in arguably the best Division II conference in the country. So they'll be a challenge for sure. This weekend we have a 3-game series, so we'll dig more into it. I played them almost every year when I was at William Woods, and they'll be very competitive and a challenge for sure, and definitely, if you want to see us on the road, Memphis is a great city. Get some barbecue, some blues, and see the Cougars.
Absolutely. A lot of fun. Let's talk about some of the guys that you touched on a little bit of your pitching staff, but who are some of the other players that you have brought in here to kind of kick things off? Talk a little bit about some of your players that you're going to lean on heavily to get this program started.
We've got a good mix of freshmen that I think are very capable. There are going to be good players in our league immediately, and some junior college transfers that'll have an impact. I think that blend is really important, not only as you build a new program, but just in general in our league. I mentioned earlier our league's very good, and you need that impact of JUCO guys. We have a few guys. I'm going to leave a couple out, but the JUCO guys, Andrew Warner, he hit our 3-hole all weekend, had a good weekend. He's he catches, plays right field, first base. Ethan Hauser. He hit in the 2-hole, had a good weekend. Those are a couple of JUCO guys that hit at the top of our lineup. A few freshmen, Kenny Piper from Hazelwood Central in St. Louis. He led off, played short, and caught a game for us and had a great weekend. Jordan Wright played center field all 4 games. He's from Sycamore, Illinois, just outside of Chicago. A really good center fielder, has a bright future. And then Justin Randall's a left-hand hitting freshman from the San Diego area. He played left field 3 of the 4 games this past weekend, and had a good weekend at the plate, homered, did some good things. So those are just a few. Like I said, you leave some guys out when you try to just scratch the surface of your team, just to hit on a few highlights from over the weekend.
Certainly, and as you said, building the program, you're going to have that. You got the transfer from Lincoln Senior, you got some JUCO, you got to have the whole range. Obviously, next year is a little bit different because you're only bringing in, as you mentioned, 8 or 9 or whatever the numbers may look like at that point, but a mix of some kids that are both from this area, and then St. Louis, San Diego, scattered around Illinois, Chicago, Minnesota, all kinds of different areas, and that's kind of what you have to do to build this program. But it gives a whole group of kids from this local area. I know Coach John Klein with the women's soccer program being new, there's so many girls that are from local high schools able to play here, and I think you'll have a legit chance, obviously, to get some of the best high school baseball players to stay at home or in this area and play for Columbia College.
Yeah, and we're very fortunate. The baseball in Missouri is very strong. So we're in an area where we don't have to just exclusively go outside of Missouri. I think of our 37-man roster, I believe 24 are from Missouri. That's off the top of my head, but we have a good group from Missouri, or 27 maybe, but it's about 3/4 of our roster. And we're fortunate because there's a lot of good high school baseball in this area. I've built a lot of relationships over the years, and our Missouri JUCOs are very, very strong. So it helps when you're recruiting. You don't have to go that far from home to find good players.
Well, certainly, and with your time in the conference and it being in the area, obviously you've still got those relationships built with a lot of the high school coaches and the programs, and you just get them to change the color. go from maroon to blue and gold, or blue and gold. What? Blue and white and silver.
I thought maybe you'd tell me something I didn't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, so yeah. Sorry, no, Bob Bertrand, if you're just finding out, we're switching back to the blue and gold for the home opener. No, March 3rd and 4th, not only is it the home opener, but conference play. Even more important, getting a chance to see the team in person. I can already see now a bunch of people out there at Atkins watching the team play the home games out there on the 3rd and 4th. Talk about Williams Baptist. I know it's a couple weeks away, but they're a team in that conference that's right there pushing for the top.
Yeah, they're always very competitive. That'll be a fun weekend. It's, like you mentioned, our opening weekend. I know we're expecting some alumni back from the previous teams in the 80s. And I've gotten, so many people have texted, called, emailed about, we can't wait, you know, we can't wait to get out there. So I know, Cosmo, you mentioned the dates, but that'll be a fun weekend. As far as Williams Baptist goes, I mentioned it earlier, but our baseball conference in the AMC, that literally every weekend is a dogfight. I mean, you don't have a weekend off. Everybody's very competitive. You'll see at least two good arms and usually three good arms on the weekend. So we'll be prepared, and I'm sure they will too. We look forward to it.
Yeah, the full schedule, ColumbiaCougars.com, and a lot of mix of some weekends. I know, like this past weekend, you know, four games, one day doubleheader, up or two different times. There's going to be a 7-inning game, a 9-inning game, and some doubleheaders up and down the roster, the schedule. How does conference work for most of the time? Is it two games, three games? Talk a little bit about what people might see on the schedule when it comes to the meat of the conference schedule.
Sure. We play three-game conference weekends. It's usually a Friday 1-9-inning game, and then the Saturday is a doubleheader, and it's a 7 and then a 9. Sometimes that's flip-flop. It just depends on if that school or their facility has lights or not. But it's a combination of 1-7 and 2-9s over the weekend. So it's good conference baseball. And with that setup, with 11 teams in our league, you know, you play a 30-game conference schedule. So you really find out who the better teams are, and it's very fair.
Well, Coach, off to the 2-2 start, but it's finally here. You're putting on a uniform instead of just kind of hanging in the office. And congratulations on the start. It seems like it was just yesterday that the announcement was made. And here we are with baseball back at Columbia College. Congratulations, and good luck on the start and the rest of the games in Memphis this weekend.
Well, thanks a bunch, Cosmo. I really appreciate you having me on, and look forward to having folks out to see us play this season.
Coach Darren Munns, again, this coming weekend in Memphis. You want to make a road trip, go see the Cougar baseball team, the full schedule. Start meeting some of the student-athletes that are play ball here for the Cougars online at ColumbiaCougars.com. And then again, that home weekend, the 3rd and 4th, as Williams Baptist comes to town for the first home baseball game in 35 years for the Columbia College Cougars. Again, online, ColumbiaCougars.com. Thanks for watching Cougar Insider here on MediaCom Channel 22.
Prime TV and On Demand, we can catch up on our favorite series anytime.
With Prime TV, there's always something for them, like this or this, with Kids On Demand.
That's why I upgraded. More entertainment I can watch my way.
There are lots of reasons to get Prime TV. Now just $7.95 more a month for 1 year. With thousands of on-demand choices.
And Stars and Stars Encore.
There's more for everyone. Upgrade today and save. Call 888-SIMPLIFY for details.
I told her, don't worry, we'll figure it all out.
Technology is wonderful, but it can be complicated.
When Linda called in, it was Christmas Eve. She needed help getting her daughter's new laptop set up on their home Wi-Fi.
We have a saying in our department.
Help a customer the way you'd want to be helped.
Linda was laughing. She barely knew how to get the laptop turned on. But I told her, don't worry, we'll figure it all out. And we did. I'm Jane.
I'm Ryan.
And we're here to help.
Watch Heart of America football all season long right here on MC 22.